Alrighty, so I have the injectors from RockAuto that everybody's been talking about. As you can see, I actually got this one from one location, and then these two shipped from a totally different warehouse. So they both came in separate packages, one from California, one from maybe Ohio. I can't recall right offhand, but they came from two different locations. And as you can see, you know, they are all dash 12 or index 12 or however you want to say it. So you can see dash 12 and dash 12. So these are those RockAuto ones that people say that, you know, are not OEM, but, you know, I'm going to give them a try. People seem to be having good luck with them. Yeah, they're like $115. I bought three of them because I just got this car a couple months ago. So far, I took off the intake manifold. I did the blaster, the walnut shells. I got a little kit. I already have a compressor, and I already have a shop vac around here somewhere. So I just bought that guy a box of walnut shells, and then like a couple adapters. I think it was like $150 to clean up the intake ports. Really good. What I'm having is I'm having a lot of noise in the back. Misfire on number 5. And it sounds indicative of your standard, injector pre-failure kind of thing. The car is stock, but I did put on an MHD tune recently. It seems like it's kind of escalated from there. So on top of putting in bank three, three injectors in bank two, I'm also going to do plugs. And I bought an extra coil too, just in case. I may just put that in cylinder 5, since cylinder 5 is the one that's giving me the misfire issue, just to try to weed out any possibilities. But if anything, at least I have an extra coil pack to test with. So the other thing I'll note too is these came with the clips. This one's a little bent, but that's probably fine. But they came with those like little like ring injector clips or decouplers or whatever the hell they want to call them. I bought some from ECS because I really wasn't sure if I was going to get them, and I wanted to do them before the weekend. So I just wanted to get everything. I'll probably end up maybe keeping these or sending them back. And they're like $32 for these stupid little clips, and it comes with it anyway. But it's not really clear. Some guys get them, some guys don't. So, you know, as of this recording, it's December 19th, 2015. It's safe to say you'll probably get them if you order them through RockAuto. Now, people say don't get these because these are potentially Chinese knockoffs or Chinese ripoffs or any of that shit. I mean, you can see it's got the roundel there. I mean, I could fake a roundel. Anybody can do it. I mean, you can't put it past like a Chinese company. But the thing I've learned is that a lot of times, I mean, BMW is not making these injectors. They're having some sort of third party make it and slap their name on it. You know, that's just the cold reality of it. But these are pretty safe to assume that they're going to work. People have had good success with them. And honestly, I bought this car for $13,000 cash, and at the end of the day, it's a $13,000 car, so I'm not going to go spend fucking $400 for an injector from the BMW dealership when it's not really, you know, if it was like a $40,000 car, sure, maybe. But it's a $13,000 car, so it doesn't really warrant it. But anyway, I already marked these. I wrote down on my bench over here the three cylinders in reverse order because I figure I'm going to be pulling 4, 5, and 6. It's just easier for me to write it backwards. But anyway, so I recorded down what the new numbers are going to be. I still have yet to pull it apart and start pulling out the injectors. So we'll see what it kind of looks like when I pull them out. Another thing to note, when I bought the car, I did call the dealership that it was getting serviced at, and they told me that bank one injectors were replaced about eight months ago. So I'm assuming that my noise is coming from the rear three injectors, that the second bank. So it sounds like it's coming from back there. I haven't done the actual test. I've seen people online do it, but anyway, we're gonna just do 4, 5, and 6, and code them all the same. They're all the same index, so it should be no problem. I mean, I figured I'm going to have to replace all three of them anyway. And since the front three were replaced most recently, most likely it's the rear three. And the service history that I got from the dealership, they were kind enough to kind of tell me some things. They did say that, cylinders 4, 5, and 6 were last replaced in 2011. So, you know, it's good about four and a half years ago. So safe to assume my culprit is those rear cylinders. And like I said, I just bought this car, so I have no clue if the plugs are good or not. I don't know when the last time it's had new plugs put in or new coils, so I wanted to get an extra of that anyway. So all together, I think I'm out maybe about $500 total on everything here. And then for the media blasting for the walnut shells, about 150. So I'm only about $650 into this thing. And I got it cheap because it didn't sound good when it was running and I got a good deal. So let's see if we can kind of rectify this. As for the second part, you can't just slap these guys in there and expect it to work. You got to record down those numbers there, which are going to be your flow rate. Let me zoom in on that. It's going to be your flow rate number. So each one of these, of course, is different. And there's other videos out on YouTube that I've watched and others have probably watched. So you know to record, write those down because you've got to program those with INPA. Let me try to focus in here. So INPA, I've got it running on my MacBook. If you are looking for help getting INPA set up, I found this guide to be most helpful. And maybe I'll put a little link in the description. But if you simply type in this verbatim DIY N54 injector coating, maybe without the one in the brackets there, you'll find the website that this references. And there's even a link in here to download INPA. For whatever reason, everybody seems to be super secretive or not as helpful about setting up INPA. It's like piecemeal trying to find like a clear, good guide to guiding you through it. And a lot of my issues of getting INPA to work in my virtual environment were not related to the virtual environment, but more the port setup along with the INPA setup, because depending on the port that yours commands, like in this example says COM5, if your INPA is set up for COM1, then it's not going to be able to connect. Even though your computer sees the cable, the cable will not be able to communicate with INPA because it's not calling the right port. So, you know, to get around that, you would program in, let me see if I can find it somewhere in here. Oh, right here. So like you would go into these INI files and make sure that you set the port to whatever yours is corresponding to. Mine, in my case, was COM3. So I set this INI, there's a couple other INIs, and then you got to put one in the Windows directory as well. But this guide kind of lays it all out nice and perfect. I found it super easy, and I was able to connect INPA, and I know it works on my laptop in that virtual environment. And the cable I'm using is the cheap, I'll put a link of this in there too. But it's this cheap, eBay special deal, Amazon special. It's $19 on Amazon, and it's got hit and miss reviews because I think a lot of people are having issues setting it up. Those that can get it to work with INPA, like myself, but others get frustrated and they just shit can this thing and buy the expensive $100 one. Again, this is a $13,000 car, all right? I'm not going to go spending too crazy amount of money on it when, you know, I can get stuff that's cheaper that'll work. Sorry guys, the video cut off. But what I was saying is basically that it's just these cars are becoming cheaper in value. And I mean, if the cheaper stuff's gonna work, it's gonna work. You don't have to spend a shitload of money just to maintain the status quo of having all these high end, and I say that in brackets, high end parts, when these will work fine. And honestly, these are probably coming from the same factory that the fancy BMW OEM ones are. You know, like I said, you'd be surprised. A lot of manufacturers, BMW does not make their own injectors. There's no BMW branded injector. They're typically going to be made from some other manufacturers and rebranded as BMW. So why the fuck would anyone want to spend too much money? Anyway, so I'm going to start ripping the car apart, and maybe I'll get some video of putting in the new injectors and encoding it with the laptop. So, all right, thanks. So as you can see, just starting to rip into everything. I got all the crap over there. And so yeah, I'm like looking at these injectors and my suspicions are right. If you look down there, you can see the number on the injectors. And you can see one, two, and three are all dash 12s. I'm not sure if it's coming through on the video too well, but yeah, they're all dash 12s. At least the first three are. So let's see if we can get one of these motherfuckers. Well, yeah, you can kind of see a 12 down there. Well, anyway, they're dash 12s. And then the ones in the back, they look like they're dash 7s. So, you know, that's what I was expecting. That this is number 4 we're looking at right now. So you see -7, and then this is number 3, which is part of the bank 1, and it's -12. So we have all of them. These 3 up front here are probably going to be fine. So I'm just going to go for those guys back there and see if my noise kind of goes away and if I don't have any misfires. I'm going to pull all of these coils so I can get the plugs. Sorry, just fucking trying to handle all this shit and it's like a bag of dicks. All right, so anyway, yeah, I'm going to pull all these coils and put in new plugs. And then I may put number 5, I may put the new coil on that one just to weed out the possibility that it's not a coil pack issue. I highly doubt it. And the reason why I'm doing the plugs is I just don't know when they were last done, and it's probably best measured just to replace them since they're relatively cheap. And this car has 90,000 miles on it, so it's not like, you know, it's not like it's, you know, unneeded. Maybe a little unnecessary, but you know what? If it means that I have to pull the car apart less, then fuck it, I'll do that. So we'll do those 3 back there, those 3 injectors, pull all the coils out, we'll put new plugs in. Plugs I got on Amazon, you know, like probably most people on Amazon, fucking order and get everything on Amazon. And then I got this spark plug tool. It's on there as well. I think this thing was like $8. And there's like a little washer that's in there. I just pulled the washer out because it's kind of a bitch to get on the plug. But with that washer now not in there, the plugs easily slide in and out. So I'll probably just take like a little piece of electrical tape or something. I got some good shit right here. And just kind of run it around there just so that the plug doesn't fall off. Screw it in there, pull it out, take the shit off, take the tape off, and you know, kind of do that. That'll probably work. So yeah, that's where we're at. But yeah, I'm kind of glad the front 3 injectors are the newest -12s, which makes sense to me. And the rear ones are -7s or some shit. They're old as fuck. So they're gonna go, and we should be good. These compression fittings, I imagine that this fuel rail is under pressure. So I got a towel over here. So I'm just gonna kind of put that around one of these. Well, I'm not gonna pull this guy, so I'll put it around number 4 back there, probably on the top, or let's buy a big electrical connector. I don't like that, but I guess this one is anyway. So anyway, I'll probably just put this around there, try to absorb up as much fuel as I can, but it's under pressure, so like crack it slowly and just fucking, you know, take your time with it. Make sure, you know, you're not having fuel go everywhere. Make sure you don't have a fucking big bonfire going on next to your car, you know, that type of shit. So we should be all right. Alrighty. So I pulled the plugs and I pulled all the coils. One thing I did notice, so this one's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So from front to rear, right? If you look at number 4, it's really got some moisture built up there. On the inside of the plug, it doesn't look too bad. It looks pretty clear in there, I guess. I don't know, I'm gonna compare it to another one for, yeah, I mean, on the inside it looks clear. But yeah, there's definitely some moisture or something. Maybe some fuel's getting by. So maybe number 4 is my culprit and it's leaky. Maybe 5 just, whatever, threw a misfire. But, you know, like, between these 3, I'm not really sure what I'm going to do yet quite for that additional coil that I have. Maybe I'll put all 3 of these back in and just keep that one over there and see if one, you know, happens to misfire again. And if it does, and I got that one over there to test with. The plugs, you know, they don't look too bad. I mean, reading plugs, honestly, the only way you can honestly read a plug is run the car really hard, and then when you let off the accelerator, shut it down and coast. That's really the only way to read a plug. But I mean, you can see there's some oil and stuff on here. I think this is kind of normal for these type of FI cars. I mean, if you see all the plugs that came out of this thing, you'd probably laugh. But these don't look too bad, honestly. I mean, the prongs are all in place. You know, they don't look too awful. But you know, they're gonna get replaced. I got them, you know, they're cheap enough. And I don't want to have to replace them later. I mean, at some point, these have to get replaced. And I just don't know when these were last replaced. So if I do it now, then I know, like, okay, they're good. Now, this one here is a little shittier. This one came out of 3, actually. It's got a little bit more oil and crap on it. Again, you know, this is probably somewhat normal for these FI cars. But yeah, anyway, so all the plugs look actually okay-ish. But anyway, they're gonna get replaced anyway. And I'll probably just put all these back in there after replacing the injectors. And that's up next. So I got all that shit out of the way. The little tops come off and they just lift straight out. You could use like a little extension to run through the center part and just lift them straight up. So, for example, when these are in the car and they're sitting straight up like this at you, you know, you flip up this guy, which releases the connector. You just back off the connector and then you slide this through like that, and then you just lift it straight up and out. They pop nice and easy, really easy to work with. I kind of like this design. So anyway, we'll see how it goes. Oh, also the nice thing too is I totally forgot about this extension, but I have the spark plug, but I also have one of these magnetic deals. So like, it's kind of nice because when the magnet on the tip, it's actually the perfect length to kind of also help pull up the spark plugs. So like, as you can see, like I'll put it in there and you know, like it's actually like the perfect length to kind of grab them and hold on to them. So when I'm pulling them out or when I'm putting them in, you know, they slide out and in pretty easily and they're just barely holding on by the tip. I don't put a lot of pressure against it or you'll fucking break it, but yeah, it's kind of nice that I can use this and not have to worry about that fucking tape method. So, all right, onward and upward. Alrighty, so we got a little thick, got the injectors out. It's a little dark over here, apologize, but you know, the best lighting. But yeah, you can see these are sevens. So I'm gonna write down these numbers. I mean, they're not gonna go back in the car or anything, but you know, you can see these are 2-7s and this one's a -8, and I don't know what I'm looking at yet. So, you know, just looking at the plugs as they are, maybe, let me see if I got a flashlight here. So you can see this one's kind of fucking nasty looking. I mean, they're all going to be nasty looking, especially this back one. Maybe this one right here in the center is number 5. So this is, you know, 4, 5, and 6. I'm doing my numbering backwards. So if I remember showing you stuff, it's that way. Okay. But anyway, you can see that, you know, these are not too bad. This one, the tip looks kind of funky, but one thing that's kind of interesting is this one over here is a -8 actually, while these others are 7s. So you can see that the design on them is totally different too. See how it's got like that little tab right there, and these ones do not, but these ones have this bigger tab up here. Otherwise, I mean, they're pretty identical. These ones are even numbered. I didn't number those, by the way. So who knows? These, and the other thing too is a BMW dealership did these before. They told me that these are the ones that they put in 4, 5, and 6. So, you know, these two are numbered. This one's a -8. So I don't know. Fuck if I know. That's the other thing that's kind of bullshit, is everybody complains about using, you know, reworked injectors or cleaned injectors, or like using this brand injector off of Rock Auto. I'm sorry, but if BMW shit were so good, these wouldn't break every fucking, you know, 50,000 miles or start squirting and shit and leaking. So, you know what? Fuck that. That's bullshit anyway. So I'm going to throw in these Rock Auto specials and we'll get to coating them. But just thought I'd show you, this is kind of how they came out. You know, I'm not really sure what I'm looking at with them. I'm not sure what the problem may be. They are loud as fuck, so the solenoid is definitely much noisier than any of the other ones in here. So we'll replace all three of them. I got -12s in the first bank. We'll have -12s in the second bank, which should be good to rock and roll. So stay tuned. Just another little quick note. On these injectors, these are the new ones, of course, right? So on the bottom, you got this little cap. It's got to come off. It's kind of a bitch to get off. So, I mean, maybe I'm just being a weakling. But anyway, I'm just like slightly tightening it in my vise and then pulling back on it and it comes right out. So, I mean, you should be able to pull this sucker right out. Let's see. I don't know. Yeah, it's just tight as fuck. But anyway, I'm just popping it in this guy here. Sorry, I can't really see it at the moment, but I'm popping in the vise. I'm just tightening around that collar a little bit. As you can see, and I just twist a little, and it'll start to come right out. So anyway, once that's popped out, you'll see there's already a seal on it, but in the container, it comes with an extra seal and that clip. So I'm guessing this seal stays on, and that clip goes on over it. So to get that clip on over this, I suppose you should probably leave this guy capped, but to get the seal or this clip over it, you gotta bend this little leg up. This came bent, sorry about that. This came bent, so you just bend that back, kind of make sure that all the prongs look normal, and then you slide this over. If it goes over and it doesn't really line up into place, like you see, this one was bent out, this one's bent out. I'm just gonna kind of make it more better, I guess. Some guys reuse this. It doesn't look like it's a crush washer. It kind of is, but I don't know. You know, I do have the ones from ETS that they sent me, but I'm sure these are fine. So I'm just going to roll with these and probably send those back because, you know, it's 30 bucks. Or maybe I'll just hold on to them in case I have to do this again. And I'm not sure if the injectors I'll get, you know, come with these little clips. But anyway, and you just slide it on. It kind of just rests in there, you can see. And it'll turn around and flip and stuff. I mean, so do the old injectors, but that's it. And then basically take this cap off, slide it in there. Some guys will put a little lube on the end here. So I'll probably do that and then use the bracket to push it down. All this is in another video. I'm just trying to add like supplemental shit to see if, I don't know, these RockAuto ones will work, but they're the same. So when I go over there, I'll take the cap off, plop her in there, and then I'll start working the brackets on them. So, all right. Alrighty, so out with the old, in with the new. I buttoned up the car, well, for the most part. So I've got my numbers, the old ones on top. I just put an extra room, so when I'm programming, I make sure I use the new numbers. But anyway, it came out, all these injectors came out pretty good. The one thing I will note is, because I was doing bank two, which is the last three injectors, I believe. Since I did bank two, I didn't take this injector out, number three, because it's hooked up to that same bracket down there. Three and four, three being from bank one, four being from bank two, share the same bracket on the bottom down there. My little light, you little bastard, go back on. All right, so anyway, they share the same bracket down there. So all I did was I took the bracket out, of course, but I left, number three where it was. I didn't bother to take, what the hell? Little battery light, son of a bitch. All right, anyway, I just hold this. So yeah, I took out the bracket, but left the injector in there. And then when I put the new injector in there, I just seated it down as best as I could. And, you know, I didn't put a ton of pressure. I let the bracket do the work. The other thing too is that the bracket has a bow to it. So when you take it out, it's pretty apparent which way it goes, but I'm trying to demonstrate with this piece of cardboard. There's like a slight bow in it, like that, say, right? So there's a bow like this, and the bolt goes in through the top and down. So it's like an upside down U, or an N shape, I guess, or whatever. But anyway, that's the, when you're bolting it down, it applies pressure and flattens it out. If you flip it the wrong way like this, well, it's gonna be a V. So if I drive a bolt in the center here, it's not really applying pressure on either side. So just make sure that, like anything you do with these cars, just when you take it out, note the way it's come out, note what the differences are, and lay it out so it makes sense. So, you know, like if you're taking out all these injectors, lay them out so that they make sense. You know, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, keep that, you know, as your convention. But also too with parts, just if it has like a uniqueness to it, like those brackets where it's bowed, just make sure it goes in the same way it came out. I've heard some guys had issues with they flipped the back brackets the wrong way and tried putting it in, and then it doesn't seat the injectors properly and all that other bullshit. Anyway, so yeah, so I tighten everything else up. I gotta fire up INPA and do the programming. I just put all the stock coils back in there. I figure I'll get it running, make sure it's driving and idling fine, and then if I take it for a drive and I experience any more misfires, I'm gonna assume it's probably a coil at that point. We'll see.
So I got my $19 cable here from Amazon. I got it plugged in. I got my car in the on position, so I'm gonna plug it into my MacBook here. You won't have to worry about this added step. I'm running VMware, so I'm going to connect the USB to my Windows VM environment. And this is already pre-configured. Like I said, check out that guide if you're having issues with INPA. There's tons of videos out there. You should be able to get a handle on it, but that one guide walked me through everything, which I don't understand why a lot of people are very secretive about this shit almost. So anyway, I have my device in here. Should be in here somewhere. This guy right here. I'm just going to check and make sure it's still on port 3, which it should be. Where the fuck are you, little bastard? That's not it. Oh, there you are. Hold on. Sorry. Wrong place. So, yep. USB port 3. So, it should be all working. So, I'm just going to fire up INPA. INPA load here. And I got on and on. So, I'm good here. I need to do E90. So, fuck. Hold on 1 second. This is kind of a nice stretch because I have to function an F9. Hold on. Fucker. Is it control F9? Oh, there it is. Function F9. So I got this screen up. I'm going to go into engine. I'm going to select N54 down here, the MSD80. And we're in here. Ah, shit, where do I go? Okay, and from here we do F9 again. All right, we're in here. There should be something that says like injecto fucking hurgligurgen or something. Oh, this one probably shift F4. So because I'm fucking on a Mac, because I'm a dumbass, I'm gonna fucking okay. Boom, here we go. So there are our numbers. Currently, I only did like I said, 4 through 6. So let's see here. Number 4, the old one was 278, 240, which down here it says 278. 240. The next one, it says 280, 208, 580. Where were you? 580, 226. So 580, 225. It's going to round up or down, I believe. According to the guy in the other video, this is kind of normal to be off a decimal point. Next one is 580, 208. 580, 208. So we'll go ahead and input the new values. So we'll start out with cylinder number 4, and it's 577211. So we will hit for number 4, it says hit function 4. So function F4 for me because I'm on a Mac, but you just hit F4. And as for this crap, so we're going to put in number 4 is 577211. So 57.7. I'm just going off the same decimal points as down below. And 211. So 2.11. And we'll hit OK. All right. 577.210. So close enough. So we'll do. Now we'll do F5. Shit.
Welcome to VoiceOver.
The fuck?
VoiceOver speaks descriptions of items on the screen.
Yeah, and can be used to turn the fuck off. Sorry, hit too many buttons here, so. Bam.
Welcome to VoiceOver.
Motherfucker. Okay, VoiceOver. Hold on. It's because I don't have the application selected. Just bear with me. I'm retarded.
Welcome to VoiceOver.
Holy fuck balls. Hold on a second. I gotta hit this shit fast.
Welcome to VoiceOver.
Motherfucker.
VoiceOver speaks descriptions of items on the screen.
Motherfucker's gonna be speaking to motherfucker. Using... You know what? I'm just gonna fucking click the button down there, because... There. Okay. So, yeah. So we're doing injector number 5. And it seems weird that it's taking the previous setting for injector 5, but whatever. So, 583.205. So, 5.8.3 and 205. Let's hit okay and make sure it looks down, looks right down below. So number 5 is 58.3 and 203. So that's off a little. That's weird. Let's see if we can reset that just for shits and gigs. So let's put in a, what was it, 3? No, it was a 5. 5. So 58.3 2.05. Hit okay. All right. Well, I guess that's just the known value that's going to take. So we'll do injector number 6, which is 576.57.6 and it is calibration of 2.25. Hit okay. All right. Outside of that little interruption with fucking doing the, I don't know, the fucking claw thing to hit all the buttons at the same time, looks like we're all set. Now, I guess from here, you would just hit this F10. I think that backs you out. So let's just hit F10. It's going to bring us out here. For shits and giggles again, I'm going to go into function F4 and just verify that my numbers are still there. Number 4 should be 57.7, which it is, and 2.11, which is 2.10, so it's close enough. Number 5 should be 58.3, and it is, and 2.05, it's close enough. And number 6 should be 57.6 and 2.25, so we're set. We're going to go ahead and back this baby out, so I'm just backing it out, and look at the glaben, whatever. Crop talk, I don't know. All right, and do you want to exit for shizzle? So that's it. I mean, it's not too bad, considering I have a VMware session. You can see I was cheating. I was using the other DIY. By the way, you know, combination of these videos and all the DIYs out there, there's no reason why you can't do this unless you just don't have the tools or the time. But, you know, you can do all this shit yourself. It's pretty cool. Alrighty, so from there, I guess I'm just going to power cycle this guy. And then we'll fire it up and see how it does. Now, it's probably going to start like a bag of dicks, like the other video I saw. But let's go ahead and start it. Actually, it started up pretty good right there. Let's just go look and make sure it's not leaking or anything. I did tighten the fuel rail pretty good, but yeah, don't see any leaks or anything. It's a little dark. Nothing's leaking. And it sounds like it's idling good. I won't be able to tell if the sound goes away until I get the lid on it. This thing sounds like a fucking bag of dicks anyway. So, you know, just stock, that's how they are. So I'll let this idle a little bit. I'll put the cover on it and I'll take it for a drive. But I think that's pretty much it. We'll see how she goes.